Back to Britain's Best Dish, the Celebrity Special. Now, you wouldn't ordinarily pick a left-wing background against a former blue team, but the Best Dish Kitchen is a great lesson. So let's see how things have been unfolding for Derek Patton and Janet Ellis in the Battle of the Main Courses.
After putting on some eggs to boil, Derek makes a broth from sautéed onions, fennel, carrots and celery, flavoured with saffron and fish stock. This will be the base of his sauce. Derek then briefly poaches prawns, salmon, haddock and sea bass pieces in the broth.
We've got some pretty special ingredients. Yeah, the stock looks lovely. The saffron, all the vegetables.
The lovely fennel in there.
And the
fennel
is going to give a gorgeous flavour. And the saffron in there.
He blades the poached. For his sauce, Derek makes a roux from melted butter and flour before adding the broth, milk, mustard and yoghurt and mixing it together.
It's a bit tricky using yoghurt because it can split quite easily under heat. Mm. It can separate if you get the fat.
He then pours water over the spinach to boil it.
I never thought boiling spinach was a good idea. You can pan fry a little bit of fat and touch of olive oil if you want to use butter. Lovely. When you do that to it, it becomes tasteless. Silage!
Once the eggs are done, Derek chops them and adds them to the fish. The spinach is placed on top before the whole dish is covered in its homemade sauce.
Yes, never seen such a liquid sauce on a fish pan.
Derek's pie topping is made from potatoes mashed in their own skins and finally, you break pound bread on top before baking the pie for around 25 minutes.
Because the skin's still on the potatoes, then it'll have a nice crisp crust on it.
Derek tosses together peas, broad beans and green beans in sherry vinegar, butter and lots of fresh mint to serve on the side of the pie.
I mean, this part of this dish I love with the sherry vinegar, fresh green vegetables, yeah. And a dash of sherry vinegar, loads of beans in there.
Meanwhile, in the rival kitchen, Janet is tackling her sea bass dish. After parboiling the potatoes, she then drops butter over the top and puts them in the oven to roast. Next, she wraps pancetta around the asparagus, placing the wrapped sauce in a grease pan to cook alongside the potatoes.
Usually you blanch it first to get a little, hydrate the asparagus, and then roast it. So I'm intrigued to see what the asparagus is going to taste like. Is it going to taste sort of roasted charred?